How did we get here?
The show must go on.
Happy Halloween, RHS. And I'm Ethan Kankula.
And I'm Brittany Marion.
And this is your Halloween special episode of Daily Dose.
This year, Halloween falls on a Friday, so there's plenty of time to get out there and celebrate. Brittany McIntosh asked some RHSers about their plans.
Hey, I'm Brittany, and I'm here to talk with a couple people about what they're doing on Halloween.
What are you doing this Halloween?
I will be going out trick-or-treating and just enjoying it with my family and my cousins.
Are you going to be dressing up as anything?
Probably.
What are you going to be dressing up as?
Maybe something like a zombie, something scary.
What are you doing this Halloween?
This Halloween, we have a bunch of friends we're going to get together. My husband owns a gym, so it's like this big space. So we're going to show a movie on the wall and have food and barbecue and dress up, and it'll be awesome.
So all of you guys are dressing up?
I believe so, unless you're lame.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
Have a safe Halloween, everyone. Now back to you, Anchor.
That's one way to celebrate the holiday. Another thing to do is hunker down and watch all your favorite scary movies. Derek Patterson asked some suggestions.
Hello, RHS. I'm Derek Patterson, and we're here to see what spooky movies people are into. What's your favorite Halloween movie and why?
The Conjuring, because it's really scary.
It's probably either the Halloween Town series or Twitches 1 and 2, because I would watch those every day.
I would have to say the original movie Halloween. Michael Myers was just so terrifying in it, and it was one of the originals. So,
the Nightmare on Elm Street series with Freddy Krueger was probably my favorite.
I always liked the Nightmare on Elm Streets because they were just always scary and fun to watch with the family.
What's your favorite Halloween movie character and why?
Hands down, Michael Myers in the original Halloween. Terrifying, scary, hulking.
Jason, he was really scary in the movies.
Oh, that'd have to be Freddy Krueger because it's just, I like the way he scares people. It's hilarious.
Probably the Winnie the Pooh characters, because when we were younger, my family and I, we'd all dress up in different characters.
Well, there you have it, RHS. There are some of the horror our students and teachers are into. Now, back to you, anchors.
Those are some good ones, but I like Ouija. What about you, Britt?
My favorite is Hocus Pocus. But that's not my favorite thing about Halloween.
What is?
I love craving pumpkins.
Craving pumpkins? Ooh, like pumpkin spice lattes from Starbucks.
I meant car pumpkins.
Well, I like to see haunted plays. And I have a show opening tonight at 2730 Bagley. It's called 2730, and it's about a haunted theater, the history of Matrix. Come check it out tonight at 9 o'clock.
Kayla Watson asked people to show how they
carve
their
pumpkins. Let's take a look.
Hey, RHS. I'm Kayla Watson. Halloween is here. The pumpkins are carved and ready for action. Let's take a closer look. If you were a jack-o'-lantern, what face would you make?
I'd probably make a face with crossed eyes and a zigzag mouth, although I'm not exactly sure how I would do a zigzag mouth.
If you could be a jack-o'-lantern, what face would you make?
It would have to be something scary, but then something that also knows how to have fun.
Could you show us this? That's great. If you were a jack-o'-lantern, what face would you make?
Okay, do you want to make it first?
Beautiful, beautiful.
So I guess the eyes would be kind of slanty, and then the nose would be pushed up. And the mouth would just be like, oh.
If you could be a jack-o'-lantern, what face would you make?
I think I would have to go for something with, like, you know, like big eyes and then like teeth, yeah. but tongue, like, ah, you know?
Yeah.
So kind of like, ah, ah, ah.
Get ready for Halloween, RHS. I've been Kayla Watson. Now back to the anchors.
Go. You know, I always thought my pumpkin would look something like this, you know, like with the top, and then like this, and then like come like together like this, and then like...
Nice, then, like, well...
Don't all these Halloween traditions get you wondering where it all began? Sam Phillips is here to give us a little history lesson.
Hello, I'm Sam, and I've always wondered where the origin of Halloween comes from. Now, I did my research, and I went and found out. Now, here's the origin for you. Halloween is a shortening of All Hallows' Eve, which comes from the Celtic festival, Samhain. Shawan is also marks the end of the harvest season for crops and vegetables that they always grew. This day is also the day that marks a transition over to winter. So obviously if you didn't harvest, the crops would die. Anyways, the boundaries of the two worlds would collide on this day, the living and the dead. The deceased would cross over into the life of the living and cause havoc to us. To prevent this havoc from happening, the pagan ritual day of merriment was always performed. That's when costumes, parades, and of course treats were given out to the people for day of merriment, which would prevent the dead from coming back. We'd all have a great time, which then of course brings us to the end of Halloween. Thanks for listening. Now back to the anchors.
Wow, Hallow's Eve has been around forever.
Brittany, I don't think we should be in here.
What?
We hope you have fun in the sick Halloween, all right, Jess?
We leave you with Boo.
I really do like the candy.
Is that on camera? Oops.